What up, everybody? What up, everybody? Let me get to the spot. Hey, everybody, what is going on? This is Plan Your Greatness, and I am your gracious host, Carlton Hamilton. And let's get started today. Today is Woke Wednesday. Yes, it is. And I've got a question for you. What does 100% effort in life look like? We're going to talk about that on Plan Your Greatness here on Woke Wednesday.
This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America.
Hey, we are back. We are back. We are back. We are here on Woke Wednesdays on the Plan Your Greatness channel. And we are asking the question, what does our life look like when you give 100% effort? Interesting. It's a very good question. And so more specifically, I want to ask you the question. If you gave 100% effort in your life, what would that look like? Now, as we go along a little further, are you giving 100% toward being the best person you can be? Because we have this thing going around. I mean, there was a song with Lil Duval, whatever his name is, with Snoop. And before that, there were these hashtags and memes going around. I'm living my best life. I'm living my best life. I'm living my best life. So I asked the question, are you living your best life? And some of you would go, yeah. But then I want to ask you specifically, are you giving maximum effort to live your best life? Or are you masking a raid around in giving mediocre effort and then just saying, hey, this is the best I can be? And I think that's what a lot of us tend to do. We give less than 100% effort and then we just go, that's my best. So that's what I want to challenge you to do, is understand that just accepting mediocrity and then calling that your best life, you don't want to live in that space. Because then what people end up doing is, when I asked the question, I said, are you giving your best effort to live your best life? And then they'll go, no. And I said, why not? Just a simple question, like, why aren't you? And then I started getting this laundry list of all my parents, my siblings, my coworkers, my this or that, my ex, a whole list of stuff. Then they're telling them these are the people that are stopping them from living their best life. And then I go more specific. I said, how are they stopping you from giving 100% effort toward your best life? And then I asked, I said, and why would they? Why would it be in their interest or whatever it is for them to be doing these things that's stopping you from living your best life? Because this goes back to the beginning question. What does 100% effort best life look like? What does it look like if you are giving 100%? And most of us, we just have really no idea on what's going on and what does it mean or what does it look like? Because then if I go down that list of questions, if I ask you, I said, you know, what's stopping you? How is somebody stopping you? Why would they want to even stop you? What can you do about it? How can you go about, you know, stopping them or whatever? Once you start asking those questions, you know what's going to happen? You know what it's going to come down to? It's going to come down first and foremost that you're making excuses as to why you're not giving 100% effort toward being the best person you can be. And the last thing in that, and the one that actually hits really close to home, is you are giving somebody else control over where you are in life and your happiness. Now, let me tell you this story. I call it the butterfly example. All right, there's this girl and she was attending one school and she didn't like that school. So then she transferred to another school. She didn't, you know, did everything didn't go as well as she thought at the new school, so she transferred back to the old school. Well, when she got back to the old school, she got involved. She met somebody. Oh, yeah. Figured out that they were really feeling each other. So now these two get into a relationship. And in the course of their relationship, the one girl who stayed at the school tells the girl who moved from one school, moving back to the other school, hey, look, there's a trip that I'm taking in the summer. I'm going to be gone for about 6 weeks. You know, it's a great educational opportunity. It's a great leadership opportunity. And it's a great personal development opportunity. So this girl's like, okay, cool. Yeah. So all of a sudden it's getting closer. And so I hear from the one girl, she goes, man, old girl gonna be gone for 6 months in the summer. I don't know what I'm gonna do with myself. And I said, well, then you need to start planning to do stuff. Other than that, if you don't, you're just gonna be sitting over here mad that she took off and went and started doing her thing. Well, you know what happened? This one girl didn't plan anything. The girl took off. So the one girl who was still back in America was all, you know, the girl left me. She deserted me. And I was like, wait a minute. I said, didn't she tell you she was leaving? That was the first thing. And I said, and what is she going over there for? It's an educational opportunity. It's a leadership opportunity. And it's a personal development opportunity. So are you trying to tell me and conveying passive aggressively to the girl that she shouldn't take this opportunity and she should stay here with you and you're doing nothing? You're not traveling anywhere. You're not doing anything. You're not getting into anything. You follow me on that? Here is somebody else trying to live their best life, trying to pursue the things. And here's another person not doing anything, living in that mediocrity space and getting mad at somebody else. All right. So you see how that works? Because I'm under the impression that people who live in their best life are living that 100% best life are going to be seeking people that are also living that best life. Because you know what happened in that relationship? They're no longer together. And I guarantee, as I was telling that story, some of you be like, well, how'd they end up? How'd they turn out? They're no longer together anymore. And in my opinion, they're never going to be together anymore unless the other person decides to start living their best life and not lying to themselves that they want to live this mediocre life and they want other people to participate in their mediocre life. Because here's the deal. Living our best life is not the same as giving our best effort to live our best life. That is what we need to understand. And this is in conjunction. I didn't say this at the beginning, but this is Woke Wednesday. And this is week two of Prison Week. And one of the things that I had to learn was in order for me to move out of that space of where I was entering into the prison with this very negative mindset, very similar to this person in the example, living a life of mediocrity and wanting other people to participate in it. I said, the only way that I'm going to get out of there is I have to seek diligently in mind, embody my best life. And then what's going to happen, which has, is I start running into a bunch of other people who are looking to live their best life as well. Now, if you are in that mind space that you are looking, not just in words, but in action, that you are seeking the best effort to live your best life, you are absolutely on the path to planning your greatness. All right. Now, the call to action today on Woke Wednesday is I want you to ask either a family member or somebody close to you, ask them, say, am I living my best life? And say, if I'm not, then what are things that you see? Because a lot of times we say, hey, we're living our best life. But there's actually other people that see things and they go, you know what? How many times have we been told, man, you're better than that? I think I see more things for you. And a lot of times we have to get outside ourselves and maybe ask someone else. So that's what my challenge is. My call to action to you is ask somebody else who's going to give it to you. Honestly, are you living your best life? And then you look at that. And then you start moving in that direction. All right. So make sure you hit the share button, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you can get the updates of when we go on live. We're also on Twitter and Instagram. You'll get some updates. You'll get some notifications. We're just doing everything. And so just keep an eye out for us. We're going to be trying to do some other things. We're going to be expanding into maybe a live podcast on Sundays. And I will leave you with, as I always do every week, plan your greatness. You know why? Yeah, because no one else will. I will see you all next week on Woke Wednesdays. You guys take care and have a great rest of the week.